children, good morning. We have already started our social second lesson. What's the name of the lesson, children? Yes, globe, the model of the earth. What's the name of the lesson, children? Globe, the model of the earth. Shall we recollect all the points, children? Yes. This is called globe. So the model of the earth. So why the people made this globe? Because we cannot see the whole earth at a time. Just we can see only minute, a small part of the earth. So the people made this model of the earth. And who was the first man who made this model of the earth, children? Yes, Martin Behaim is the first man who made the model of the earth. In which year? 1492. And what is the name of that person? Martin Behaim is the first man who made the model of the earth. In which year? In 1492. Why he made the model of the earth? To study more about the earth. And what is the importance of the earth? And what are the things present on the earth? To study all these things, they made this model of the earth in 1492. And what's the name of the person? Martin Behaim. Okay, you have already learned that there are two points on the globe, and these two points are called poles. This is called North Pole and this is called South Pole. So next, and what are the two colors you observed on the globe, children? Yes, one is yellow colored, that is land. So large land masses are called, what are large land masses, children? Continents. The large land masses are called continents. And the blue color on the globe, what it indicates, what it shows? The water bodies. And large water bodies are called oceans. So you have already learned what are continents and what are oceans in the previous video. So now tell me, children, how many continents we have? Yes, we have seven continents on the earth. And how many oceans? Five oceans on the earth. How many continents? Seven continents and five oceans on the earth. So continents means nothing but large land masses. Land, simply we can say land. So large land masses are called continents. And what are called oceans? Water bodies. Large water bodies are called oceans. Large water bodies are called oceans. And you have already learned which is the largest continent, children? Asia. Asia is the largest continent. And our country lies in Asia continent. Continents means nothing but it consists group of countries. Continent contains, continents have countries. And five oceans, which is the largest ocean, children? The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean. So you have already learned in the previous video. So today we are going to learn one more topic, that is maps. What's our topic, children? Maps. For example, see, on the globe, can you see all the places clearly on the globe? This is the whole world on the globe. Whole world. So, for example, I will show you India. This is our country, India. Can you see our country very clearly on the globe? No, it is very small in size and we cannot see our country very clearly. We cannot see our country very clearly on the globe. If you want to see our country very clearly, we need very big globes. But it is not easy because it is very difficult to carry. It is very difficult to carry a big globe from place to place. Clear, children? So this is our country, and our country has so many states, and we cannot see our country very clearly on the globe. So we take the help of maps. Now you can see our country India very clearly in the map. On a map, we can see our country very clearly. But on the globe, we cannot see our country clearly. Clear, children? So on the map, we can see our country very clearly. Clear, children? So then tell me, what is a map? Map is nothing but a drawing of the earth or any part of it. So here, this is a whole world on the globe, but we are not draw the whole world on the map. Just we draw a part, that is our country, a part on a sheet of paper, that is called a map. Now tell me, what is a map? A drawing of the earth or any part of it. It is part. India is a part of our earth. And now you can see, this is a whole map. This is old map. See here, our country lies here. This is our country. And this is the Asia continent, whole Asia continent. Clear, children? So, map, what is a map, children? Now tell me, what is the definition of map? A map is a drawing of the earth or any part of it. And globes, what is the difficulty in globe? What is the disadvantage? Globes, the big globes cannot carry easily from place to place. And these maps can roll very easily. See here, this is a map. And I can roll the map very easily. And it can easily carry to any place. But in globe, it is very difficult to carry from place to place. But in map, we can easily roll and it can easily carry to any place. And most of the teacher uses the map to locate different places and to show all the places to the children very clearly. They are called wall maps, which can hang on the wall. These are called wall maps. Teachers uses a maps to show the different places to the children in the class. And can hang on the wall. And these maps are called wall maps. Clear, children? Teachers use it to show the places to the students in the class. And these maps are called wall maps. Clear, children? Okay. For example, we can see a book of maps. See, this book contains lot of maps. World map, India map. So it contains, see, India map. So a book contains a large number of maps, and that is called atlas. It contains a book of maps. Clear, children? So a book of maps. What it is called? Atlas. Atlas is a book of maps. See, it contains lot of maps. This is called atlas. And on the map, how you can locate the places? With the help of four directions. With the help of how many directions? Four directions. See, what are the four directions? This is north. This is south. This is west. and this one is east. With the help of these four directions, we can easily locate the places on the map. On the map, how you can locate the places? With the help of four directions. How many directions, children? Four directions. With the help of these four directions, we can easily locate, or you can easily see the places in the map. Clear, children? What are the four directions? North. North is the top part of the map. So this is the north. Top of the map is called north, and bottom of the map is called south, and towards the left is called west, and right is called east. See, children? North, the top of the map is called north, and south, bottom of the map is called south, and west, left side of the map is called west, and right of the map is called east. Clear, children? So with the help of these four directions, we can easily locate the places on the map. So this is about the maps. What is a map, children? Tell me, what is a map? Map is a drawing of the earth or any part of it. On the globe, we cannot see the places very clearly on the globe. If you want to see, very big globes are required, and very big globes are very difficult to carry from place to place. So map is drawing of the earth or any part of it, and the teachers use maps to show different places to the children. They are called wall maps, and these wall maps can be easily rolled and carried to different places. And on the map, we can easily locate the places with the help of how many directions, children? There are four directions on the map. What are the four directions on the map, children? One is north, the other one is south, the next one is west, and the last east. So north is the top of the map. Top of the map is called north, and bottom of the map is called south, and towards the left of the map is called west, and the right of the map is called east. So with the help of these four directions, we can easily locate the places on the map. Okay, and the last topic, that is compass. So for example, when you see on the map, see, this is a compass. This is called a compass. When you observe on the map, every map, they will have a compass, and this compass is used to find the directions on the map. See here, north, south, west, east. Clear, children? On the map, you will find a compass, and these compass will have four directions: north, south, west, and east. And this compass helps to locate the places on the map. And compass looks like a watch. Another compass is there, that it will have a magnetic needle at the center of the compass. In the center there is a magnetic needle, and this needle always points to the north. Example, when some sailors travel in the ship, sailors means a person who travel in the ship. When they travel on the ship, all the four directions seems alike, means same. All the four directions same, look same, and they don't know in which direction they want to go. So at that time, they use this compass, and this compass, they have a magnetic needle, always shows the north direction. If we know one direction, you can easily calculate the remaining three directions. If it is north direction, and the opposite is south, and towards the left is west and towards the right is east. So most of the time this compass is used by sailors in the oceans. In the oceans all the four directions look same. They don't know in which directions they have to go. So this compass looks like a watch. It is called compass. Actually you find a compass on the map. You find a compass on the map and this compass help to find the directions on the map. See here, north, south, west, east. So with the help of these four directions you can easily locate the places on the map. And one more compass, that is, it looks like a watch. It is an instrument which looks like a watch. For example, in pictures you will see most of the people, they carry compass when they go to forest or any place. They use this compass to locate. So the compass looks like a watch. It is an instrument which looks like a watch. And this watch will have a magnetic needle. One needle is there at the center. And this point always shows the north direction. Always points or always shows the north direction. If we know one direction, then we can easily find the remaining three directions. Because the opposite to north is south and towards left is west and towards right is east. So we can easily calculate the remaining three directions. And this compass is mainly used by the sailors. Clear children? Okay. Okay, shall we recollect all the points what you have learned? Map. Today our topic is maps. So map is a drawing of the earth. A drawing of the earth or any part of it. So this is a drawing of India map. On the globe, it is very difficult to see all the places on India map because it is very, very small on the globe. So the same part, if you draw a sheet of paper, that it is called a map. And on the map, you can easily see all the places in our country. So you can easily locate all the places on the map. So map is a drawing of the earth or any part of it. Clear children? Okay, and these maps are very easy to carry from place to place. Just you can roll the map. See, you can easily roll the map like this and you can easily carry to one place to another place. And the teachers use this type of maps to show the different places on the map to the children, to the students in the class. And they are called wall maps. And a book of maps. The book contains large number of maps in a book. And that book we call it as atlas. What is atlas, children? A book of maps is called atlas. Okay. And how can you identify the places of the map? With the help of four directions. What are the four directions? One is north, that is the top of the map is called north, and the bottom of the map is called south, and towards the left is called west, and towards the right is called east. Okay children, so these are the four main directions on the map and which we can easily locate the places on the map. And we find the compass on the map. With the help of this compass, you can easily locate the places. And one more compass, that is, it looks like a watch and it is used mainly by the sailors who travel in a ship. And in the ocean, all the directions look same. So at that time, they use this compass. And this compass have a magnetic needle at the center. And this needle always points or always shows the north directions. If you know the north direction, you can easily calculate here. You can easily find out the remaining three directions. Clear, children? Clear. This is the end of our lesson. What is the name of the children? Name of the lesson, children? Globe, the model of the earth. Globe, the model of the earth. And what you learn from this lesson? First one is globe. The model of the earth is called globe. And what are the two colors on the globe? And what are the two points? The two poles. The upper pole is called south pole. North pole and the lower pole is called south pole. These are the two poles on the globe. And the two colors, one is blue color and the other one is yellow color. Yellow color indicates landforms and the blue color indicates water bodies. And the large water bodies are called oceans and the large land masses are called continents. And the last topic is maps. We already learned what are maps and what are the four directions. We can easily identify the map with the help of these four directions. Okay, children, by the evening you will get your homework. Thank you.